over here, and Sister Carter or Sister Madeline will help you. And, you know, you can come over here and have your prison numbers and a smoke.
Don't keep my Bible.
Don't I look cute?
Yeah.
And there's a wig over there and one that says I was framed, and you can get your mug shot.
Yeah.
So, anyways. All right, why don't we all stand tonight? And let's bow our heads, close our lips, close our eyes, and ask the Lord to bless us tonight. Pastor Seville, would you open us up in prayer?
Father, we love you, and we're thankful for your faithfulness, God. Lord, we're thankful for the state that you've given us, God. We're thankful for an opportunity to gather in tonight to have a good time, but most of all, to sense your presence. God, I pray that you would just bless Brother Sister Carter and Madeline tonight. Lord, I pray that as they share with us the gospel of Jesus Christ, your puppets, your songs, your stories, God, anoint them, use them. God, I pray that what each young person will have a good time, but that the Spirit of God will heal their heart, draw them to a deeper relationship. Father, minister, may your name be glorified in everything said and done tonight. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Remain standing. Do I have a boy that did not get a blue ticket last night? Have a boy that didn't get a blue ticket? All right. Well, I need the helper of a boy. All right. Come and help me. Do I have a girl that didn't get a blue ticket last night? All right. You want to come and help? We are going to sing our theme song. It is no mystery. Right, that's not something we have to check out.
No.
Because we can look all around us and see that God loves us.
Right. Who went missing?
Right.
Who is the missing person?
Case of a missing person.
So you better
find out? We are going to find out.
I think there's
actually, we don't even want to know the case of the missing girl's offering.
I know that what's missing. There's no money in this offering bucket.
Oh, man.
All right, we're going to put our treasures in heaven.
Right, we're going to lay them up and let God bless us. First row girls right here. First row boys right there.
Yes.
All right, second row boys.
It's not here.
Third row boys, fourth row boys, fifth row boys, sixth row boys, seventh
row.
All right, we're done.
Come on, fourth row and fifth row.
And second row.
The rest of you girls be calm. I tell you, Joe Bartlett is what the boys are putting.
That's right.
Probably because they thought they would get in trouble if that man escaped out of the praise.
Michael's.
This is a hard case.
Either somebody stole it, the body.
Or maybe Joe Hartley, maybe he really didn't come out of the grave.
Oh, I don't know.
Are you trying to trick me? How old of a case is this anyway?
Well, it says it's well over a 1,000-year-old case we gotta solve.
There's no way we can solve a case that's 1,000 years old. We don't have any DNA evidence or anything.
I'm sorry, but...
Joe Hartley, what else does that report say?
Well, it says he went missing twice.
Missing
twice? Page 10, section 7. Isn't that after the man was reporting missing from the grave?
Yeah.
He was seen alive. Alive and walking down the road. He was seen by lots of people for 40 days afterwards. One time, he was seen by over 500 people.
How many days was this man in the grave?
See, says he was in the grave for 3 days.
Does this sound like a familiar case to you guys? It doesn't? This man was in the grave for 3 days, and then he came up missing. So there were soldiers who guarded his tomb. Do you think you have... I think we're right, Joe Hartley. I think we have it figured out. We think that it's Jesus is the missing person.
Hey, you're right! This is a report about Jesus' death and resurrection!
Yeah! So come on, Joe Hartley, I can see why he was missing the first time, because we know he came out of the grave, but didn't!
That's right, he was seen alive and well, and there was no evidence that he was in any pain after he was risen.
You know what? A lot of eyewitnesses see Jesus. It's not just a fairy tale that Jesus came back to life because there were actually people who saw him. How many witnesses, Joe Hartley?
Over 500 one time see me.
All right, now if you say, Angel, that you see me in town, okay? And you tell somebody that you see me, then they might be like, nah, I don't think she was in town. I don't think she went to town today. But if, like, this whole row says that they see me in town, I think somebody would believe this, wouldn't it? Yeah. So all that
lots
many
of
people,
witnesses.
All those witnesses. But why did he come up missing 2 times?
Well, here's the question. Is it Jesus and several of his closest friends went mountain climbing after he rose from the dead?
I love mountain climbing. So Jesus and his friends went mountain climbing.
And all of a sudden, as he was talking to his friends, he floated right up in the clouds, and he's been missing since.
So you're talking about the ascension. When Jesus ascended up into heaven, that's when he went missing twice.
Right.
But is he really missing, or do we know where Jesus is right now? Where is Jesus right now? He is in heaven.
Right, but one day he's coming back for you and I. If our hearts are clean and pure and we're saved by the blood of Jesus and we have stopped our sinning, then one day we're going to rise in the air just like Jesus did. He's going to take us to heaven.
That's exciting.
I want to be ready to see him.
I do too.
Because he's not going to be missing them.
No.
We'll be with him every day in heaven, Francie Drew. That's exciting.
It is really exciting. Can somebody tell me what Jesus is doing right now in heaven? What is he doing? What's Jesus doing in heaven right now? He is watching over us.
That's one thing.
What's something else that Jesus in heaven right now? Right, God watching us still?
Watching us.
The Bible says he went to.
Yes.
What is Jesus doing up in heaven right now? Right.
Praying
he is interceding for us.
He is
praying for us.
You know what?
Us.
How many sometimes feel like you're all alone?
Nobody notices you. Yeah.
But I want you to know, Jesus knows you. He knows your name. He knows right where you live. He knows the hurt inside, the emptiness inside. And Jesus, the Bible said, is praying for you.
Right.
That is
watching
awesome.
Over us, Joe. He's praying or interceding for us. And the Bible also says he's preparing a mansion for us right now.
A great, big, beautiful home in heaven.
I'm excited to get to go to heaven. They hung him high, they stretched him wide, he bowed his head, and for me he died. That's love, that's love. Oh, but that's not how the story ends. For 3 days later, he arose again. That's love, that's love. Oh, they hung him high, they stretched him. That's not a word we use a lot right now. Anybody know the word commendeth, but God commendeth his love? Gave it to us, right? Or God showed his love. He demonstrated his love toward us and that he died. What is your dad? Does your dad on your mom's anniversaries usually buy her flowers or chocolates? What's he doing? He's showing. He's commending his love. All right. Let's say it one more time. Romans 5:8. But God commendeth his love toward us, and that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Man. What would you think? Do you think? Let's see. If you beat me up every day, if you three girls just stand up on me and beat me up, do you think I would be nice to you? I would have a hard time, but you know what? When we all sinned and we beat up Christ and we nailed him to the cross, what did he do? He showed his love for us. Even when we were sinners and did things we shouldn't, he showed us he still loved us.
So let's say it one more time. Romans 5:8. But God commendeth his love toward us. What? Something wrong? You need my glasses? There is no purple puppet there. What are you talking about? You are crazy. Petunia, what are you doing back there?
Oh, Joe Hartley.
We're trying to learn a memory verse.
You see me.
I did. You that. I thought these kids were seeing something. You don't want me to mend them. careful going down them steps. You don't want to fall. All right, let's sing again, then we're going to play again. Actually, let's say it two more times. We'll say it one time regular, and then one time fast, and then we're going to play again. Romans 5, 8. But God commendeth his love toward us, and that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. All right, let's take a deep breath. On the count of three, let's see how fast we can say it. One, two, three. Romans 5, 8. But God commendeth his love toward us. Now while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Oh, good.
I hear very many people saying it very fast. All right, now we need to know it really good because we're going to play a game, Boys Against Girls. You see, I wrote them in reverse down right here on these pieces of paper. Romans 5, 8.
Yep. What's the...
Only the magnifying glass and
right, don't bring any other clue. Go!